Well, I used to always say better than expected, but now we have cue the fire, far worse than expected. I mean, even the Fed officials, they're throwing in the towel. They're like, this is it. I'm done. We're done here. They're calling inflation, and you know that that's a no-no word. Right, ladies? When you go out on a date, first date, you have no-no zones. You don't go there till maybe the second date. Find out, does he have money? All right, let's talk. And I know you ladies are like, that's shallow. I don't care about that. Well, like some people, I've never shown my extra finger that grows out of my chest. Are you interested? No, you are not. See, there are points that you draw the line. And the Fed should not be talking hyperinflation. No, they actually jumped the shark. They have crossed the Rubicon. And we only have two solutions as America. We can either inflate, which they're doing, or they can default, which they won't do, so they're going to inflate. But just know, in the end, it's all deflationary and it all goes. Kind of like what you witnessed in March. Remember that? That was a beautiful deflationary event. If the government would have just stepped out, let the market crash, you know, like, let the chips fall where they may. They're like, nah, that's not going to happen. And Fed officials are freaking out. You can even see them in their little freak out hotel. The Fed officials saw taper starting in mid-November or mid-December, but it's like, no, we should probably do it right now. Hurry up, let's go. And now they don't even use the word transitory because they say that's a dirty word. That's what the Fed said. Don't use that word anymore. It makes people really upset. But when you have U.S. consumer prices that outpace forecast as inflation dogs economy, we have a problem, Houston. And I know Shatner just made it into space today. Congratulations, 90 years old. But our economy is going where no man has gone before. That would be in the toilet. Higher costs for food and shelter drove prices upward. Ha! Huh. Wow, that's terrible. That's also known as stagflation. It's a hyperinflation, but the amount of money that you guys are making does not keep up with the prices. I mean, in the 70s, you had inflation, but the good news was we were revving. We had an economy. Everything was booming. It was on fire. You were making more. You were keeping up. Now you're not. And now with higher costs of food and shelter, what are you doing? Well, you're moving. From places like this, the Bay Area, California, more than half of Californians are going to leave. This is permanently. They're like, that's it. We're out of here. We can't take it. More than goodbye. Half. And if you want to know why they're moving, and government officials, let's go Brandon, will never admit that they're just, it's horrible. I lived there. 84% cited costs of living. It's horrible, along with, what else? Crime, which I can guarantee you is going to continue to go up. Why? Because the dudes don't want to be cops anymore. No, they've had it enough. And then government control, they're like, we would like you to do this, this, and that. You're like, with me? No, no, thank you. I quit. You wait about 20 more days. The chips are going to start to be eaten. Walgreens closes 5 more San Francisco stores. Well, why is that? Walgreens? Ongoing organized retail crime. Well, we'll just have to stop that with 3 cops that we now... We have 1 cop now. I mean, I worked law enforcement for quite a bit of my life. Carried a 9mm. I know, right? This guy? Crazy. But all my cop friends, they just say it's the worst ever. They actually have surgery just so they don't have to go into work. Is that crazy? Just break my leg. Do I get 3 months? Break my other leg. You know you have a job, win. You're like, no, use the hammer. And also for my homies that use the word y'all rather than, hey, you guys, just know this. You've entered phase 1 where you thought, whoa, boy, all these Californians coming over here. They better not bring over their policies. Well, I have some good news and some bad, mainly bad. I just have bad news. They'll probably bring over their policies. But they're also going to bring over their confused looks like this because they can't understand why gas prices are so cheap. Californians experience its driest summer. Hey, they have no water, you guys. Guess where they're going to go? Next door to Texas, even though it's really not next door. But this could go on for decades. The climate change, what is happening with this, with no water, It's going to continue. And the prices are going to go up and the people are going to move because they want to move to places with seasons rather than two seasons, three. California's three. Hot, dry, and smoke. And oh my gosh, President Biden speaks live.
They're like, sir, you just see those words right there? Just read off of them. That's all you're going to do right now.
Tell them that everything is great. They're actually talking about transportation, like moving stuff, supply chain. And I say, you got to look at the charts. I say a lot can be gained by this kind of knowledge. This is the S&P Transportation ETF. Yep, you can buy it if you want. This is when our economy was growing. Do you see? We're above the 200. We're doing great. We drop below the 50. That was a clear sign. We are in trouble. We have a death cross. Everything is bad. We then come out of it. Remember coming out of it? I'm like, oh, hey, maybe this is a good time to enter. Even though everyone's like, no, it's horrible. Don't. You know, we're all going to die. Sell the kids. Sell the wife. And we came out of it. And then we kept going. But we have a problem. And the problem lies, well, actually, right there. That's your top. Then we sell off. What happens next? We touch the 200. Yay! We're back up. But we are starting to roll again. So yes, no, maybe so. The truth is, around April was your top. We have since rolled over. And that might be the highest we ever get. And yes, thank you very much. Very good economy. You're now rolling over. We can now go home. Also, if you are interested in learning how to trade charts like this, I have a new course called CSU, Crypto Stocks University. And I teach you, this is the advanced. I started with swing trading. That's what I do in high school. I teach kids how to swing trade and make money. And then they have to go into bigger TA. But that one is currently, because I'm filming, is $200. It will go up from there. And I know it says zoo, so just it's 200. Just know that that's my advanced one. If you want my swing trading one, I think that's 349. And here, I'll teach you the swing trade on this in under 5 seconds. It gets beat down. It bounces off the 50. You put in a buy. You ride it. We're still hanging on there. So, yeah, you're up about 2%. If you want to start taking profits off, go ahead. And you just keep doing that over and over and over again. And then you plug your ears and you look at the charts. And that way, when you see stories like this coming in from Mr. Cox, consumer prices rise more than expected. Better than expected. As energy costs surge. Man, we just got everything surging. Well, in that, your accounts can be surging to offset everything that is going up in your life. That's just a thought. Right, guy? And actually, my guy Brandon is live right now telling us, don't worry about it, kids. The prices, the poor, it's all fine. Even this guy. Food and energy are more valuable. Variable. They're actually more valuable, in my opinion. But that's where the problem is, said Bob Dahl. Hey, how would you like to have a last name like Dahl? There you go. If you're thinking about taking this one over and running with it, it was patented in 1871. But Bob, being a chief investment officer, hopefully we start solving our supply shortage problem, but when the dust settles, inflation is not going to 2%. And I say, yes, it will if the government would stop screwing with it. But you guys wouldn't like the outcome because everything crashes. It gets very, very bad. I even said, that's how bad it is. But right now, they're just trying to hold it together. Like, everything's fine. Because when everything isn't fine, rates go up, market crashes, deflation, you can't fix that, everything's bad. But you need that kind of pain in an economy. That's what economies are. It gets really good, really bad. And it just flushes out the really bad. But now we have zombies walking all over the planet. And the governments, which are owned by the zombies, are like, well, we gotta help them. It's like having a bad kid in the family. There's always one. And if you don't know which one that is, it's probably you. And yes, we could keep doing this forever. Well, you can't. I mean, time's running out. Especially when you have debt of $228,000 per tax-paying citizen. And we're not bringing in that much moolah. Well, we are right now. But once the wheels start falling off of the truck and we have a GDP, federal debt to GDP ratio of almost 130%, and if you would like to see this, 51 out of 52 countries that hit 130,
they all default, which we are too. It just takes time. We're going to try to print our way out of this. It's not going to work. Leads to inflation, wheels fall off, and I hope you have a water source, food, and things that are actually hard money. And that means, I'm sorry, government, but your hard money is not a printer. And then we have problems. Like, there's a crisis in the economy. Well, thanks, Matt, for figuring that out. The government should pay people to go to work. Well, I mean, yeah? How about the companies pay people to go to work, and the government does nothing? I mean, look at all these ridiculous solutions. Like, right now I'm like scratching my head. What? What are you even saying, Matt? But then some politician's like, that's a great idea. Well, it's a great idea until this thing starts grinding down, right? We can't, when the government isn't able to pay its obligations through whatever it is, because, and they owe things like, so we got to pay Social Security, which is a huge part of our debt. Social Security cost of living adjustment will be 5.9 in 2022. Biggest annual hike in 40 years. And where do you think that money's going to come from? It comes from you, Jimmy and Timmy, that stopped taking stimmies, which that's going to be a tough one too. You're going to have to go get a job. Because you, Jimmy and Timmy, you have to pay for Barbara, her Social Security benefits. And the only way to pay for it is by taxing you, right? Isn't that fun? What do we got? Medicare, a trillion plus, Social Security, another trillion, interest on debt, half a trillion. And then we have unfunded liabilities, which is a very big word. But just know, at the end of the day, this all comes from you. You're going to pay for it. I know the government says that you're paying as you go along, and we will save it for you. So when you get older, it'll be all there. It's not there. It's like me giving my kids, here's 20 bucks. Save that. Put that in the car. How long would that last? I'm like, if the car breaks down, something happens, you need the 20 bucks, you need 100 bucks, just keep it there. You check it the next day, it's gone. Where'd it go? They're like, well, I spent it. You see, our government is just like our kids, and you can't teach them anything. And it's sad because a normal American, normal human, doesn't understand how this whole system works. And when I'm like, hey, you should probably really understand equities and how to trade them, because you're not going to keep up. We got stagflation right now. Inflation is going to be more than you make, guaranteed. So you have a couple options here. You can either A, make more, which, you know, good luck, or B, make more, which I try to help you. So that way, when you get your energy bill that goes up by 50%, I mean, even China, look what China's doing. They're like, that's it. Cut them off. No electricity. You know, we got to slow the spread. Us turning your lights off, it's just for 14 days. No electricity for 14. It's okay. We're the government. We're here to fix and solve. And I want to apologize for our government and everything that everyone does, for inflation and then hyperinflation, then default and then deflation. But right now is not a time to complain or like figure this out. You should be swimming. You should be paddling like as a surfer. You see that wave coming, and then you're like, oh wait, that's not a wave. That's a tidal wave. That's a tsunami. You want to paddle over that thing as. Don't surf it. Just get over it. And also yesterday, to everyone who hit the like button, thank you so much. I think you pulled me out of the YouTube bad area. So, and I never ask. I'm like, don't, like, whatever. You guys, I appreciate everything that you guys do. I hope you enjoy the jokes, and I will see you tomorrow.